And welcome to a brand new thing on this channel of mine. My name is Randomize, and this is Jak and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy, a game by Naughty Dog for the PlayStation 2. I'm playing it as part of the Jak and Daxter trilogy, the HD remake made for the PlayStation 3. And I wanted to play this game for a couple of reasons. Obviously, my channel has largely been focusing on Pokemon, but Pokemon has never actually been a game where, you know, I never grew up with Pokemon. You know, it's a surprise, I suppose, but I never really grew up with Pokemon. It was just something I came into very, very late, and I started recording straight away because I fell in love with the mechanics and I really enjoy the way it works. However, Jak and Daxter, on the other hand, is a game which I love, and I've played for ages, and I've loved, you know, for a very long time. And it's a great game. I just think it's a brilliant game, and I thought it was a game that I wanted to show you guys, and I wanted to show, yeah, I just wanted to show people playing it. Now, obviously, I don't just want to play through it, because this is a game which I've played through a lot of times, as you will probably see on the loading screen, which will come up soon. So rather than doing that, what we're going to do is we're going to do a little bit of a challenge. So I'm going to, essentially, going to take on what a couple of YouTubers, which I found out about a while ago. But they did a recording of essentially Jak and Daxter versus, where they both race at the same time. This is Teal Game Master and Sackcoms, and they did a race of this game, and it was really great. It was a really close race as well, which obviously makes everything better. You know, keeps it interesting. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to test myself against their times. So hopefully I'm going to be able to sort of do comparisons as to how good they were, to see how far I can get relative to them. We're going to record in 30-minute segments, and also I just want to see, you know, if you have this game, if you love this game as much as hopefully, you know, I do and stuff like this, then maybe you might want to pick it up again and give it a go, see how good you can be at this game. I see a lot of times, you know, on various people, whenever they do races against a couple of people, then there's often like a community to want to join in and want to sort of post on their, you know, on those YouTube videos where they got to in that video and stuff like that. And I think that's a great thing. And I think, you know, getting interaction and getting input from your audience is a great thing. So that's sort of what I was hoping to do with this. I was hoping to maybe get some people responding. I don't know. Obviously, I'm a very small channel at the moment, so. But hopefully, maybe things like this will maybe make it bigger. So anyway, as I said, we're going to record in 30-minute segments. And the first one, we're going to start off a new game. As you can see, as I said, I have played this game multiple times. We're going to replay over this save here. And, yeah, so the 30-minute starter is going to come as soon as the loading screen stops here. And, yeah, and we get to the chance to start. So, as soon as the first... We'll be watching all the cutscenes. I'll try and stay silent through the cutscenes, and otherwise just sort of give as much information as possible. So we're going to overwrite. Saving starts. Here we go.
I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that deliver our planet? How did they harness Eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Sigmus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of bringing Eco. one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Hey! Jack, old Greenstone told us not to come here.
Continue your search for artifacts in Nico. The locals must have precursor items. You know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps. Stupid precursor junk. Eek! What is that dark ooze? It sure don't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursor that built this place all the time.
Where did they go? Why did they build this crap?
Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble!
Get in there before I turn you both into ferns.
there we go, 6 minutes of cutscene, and we end up here on a geyser rock at the start of our adventure. We get the introduction here to precursor orbs, which are one of the main collectibles in this game. We also see the power cell in the distance, which we will be collecting very soon, which are obviously the main collectibles of the game. There are 101, and we're going to try and get them all. It's 100% playthrough, just seeing as I didn't mention that earlier, but yeah. So here we go, introduction to a power cell. We obviously also in that great introduction that Tina love finding out, you know, how Daxter becomes what he is, an otter, a mixture between an otter and a weasel, I think. We also get the introduction to Jack, we get the introduction to Kira, and same as the Sage. I love this game for its characters, and that's a really bad place for it to pause. There we go. So, we get Scout Flyers here. There's that's Kira, just kind of running. If you send 7 to each area, we gotta break them all. If you break all 7 in an area, you get to power cell, so hopefully. There are a few that are really nasty, I tend to miss them. There are certainly some in towards the end of this game, which are really easy to miss.
Wow! That last scout one has power cell! I'll bet if you collect all 7 in each area,
so there's Kira just repeating what I just said. Going down there is important. Down there is actually, we'll just hear about it real quick.
Will we go allow you to unfast red boxes and even activate some precursor artifacts when you get
near them? Blue Eco is easily the coolest of the Ecos. Allows you, as he says, to run fast, break boxes, allows you to activate precursor doors and stuff like this. So this door, for example, we can activate if this cutscene.
It can only be opened by approaching the door while channeling Blue Eco through your body.
Get it? Yes, we can. That's awesome. Obviously, though, we do want to grab these.
That's a Blue Eco vent. More concentrated than the floating clusters. This vent will give you a full charge of Blue Eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
So the vents are important. Some of them are capped off, and we will actually have to uncap them, which is, we do about twice over the course of the game. Lots of very early, we might even hopefully reach that in this episode. But yeah, no, I love this game for its characters. I love the characterization of it. I think Daxter is honestly one of the best characters. He's like one of my favourite PlayStation characters ever. Oh, that's funny. That ruins what was a really good run for Geyser Rock. Oh well. Yeah, no, I just love Daxter. I love the humour in this game. I love just the characters. Everything's great. We get an introduction here to what happened. There's a lovely little characteristic in this game. Whenever we just hear about Green Eco.
Pick up 50 small green ecos or one big green one to increase your health.
Yeah. So that's green eco, which is just your health essentially. There's a lovely little touch in this game, which I always like, is whenever you touch the precursor metal, which are these pink blocks there, you hear a little bass note in the music, which I think is a really nice little touch. So we get the 50 precursor orbs, which is always a good start. It's always very easy to miss one of those early ones, which is never fun. That's a good start. So let's just skip that little drop.
Good training, boys, but that's nothing compared to the challenges that lie ahead.
That is no problem. We got the rules, eh, Jeff? We love to stay in chocolate green, but we're itching to get on with our adventures.
Fine, fine. Adventure away, then. And while you're out adventuring, why don't you make yourself useful? My John Green Eco Collectors are clogged up again. Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps, then continue right there. Now, all of you, get out of here!
Okay, so we get our first example there of one of the missions that are directly given to us by one of the characters, in this case, Samus. Cerberus gives us this mission to go unclog his eco-collectors. If we were to, say, do that mission first, which obviously, which isn't what I'm going to do because this is a speedrun, and we're going to try and do the fastest way possible, and in order to do that, we're just going to quickly collect 5 orbs here. Hopefully you'll see why. But we're just going to collect 5 there. Could collect the scout fly down there, but we'll miss that just for the moment. And the reason is essentially, if I was doing this slowly, what I would probably do is I'd probably just do...
You can get this open if you power up with that zappy blue eco stuff.
So as Max just says, you can open stuff with the blue lightning bolts on it with blue eco, which is pretty cool. We're going to do this mission as well. This is just essentially, we've got to herd these... the yak owls into the pen. It's not a hard mission. It's just... can be a bit long. Just because they can be a bit uncooperative sometimes. So as I was saying, essentially, so you get a little cutscene there on some sort of Cerberus talks about the collectors. If you were to do that and come back to him, he would actually then give you another mission to do. I think he would give you one on Misty Island. Similarly, if I'd spoken to Kira, who's in the garage below Cerberus's hut, if I'd spoken to her, she'd have also given us a mission. Then she gives us one in the Forbidden Jungle. And then if you do that, she'll give you another one. So there is a nice way of sort of... There's lots of sort of dialogue, which I actually never heard the first time I played through this game, because I certainly didn't do the missions in the order that, you know, they suggest you do them. But it's interesting that it's there. It's nice that it's there. Sort of it's like a nice way of sort of directing. Anyway, hopefully that will be it. There we go.
That lazy farmer owes us a power cell.
Congrats, our next power cell, our first one in this area.
Oh, well done, my boy. You actually got those blue bags back into the pen. Now I can sleep in peace. Take this power cell
for
your trouble.
So obviously we could have spoken to him beforehand, and he would have asked us to essentially do that for him. But again, we don't want to waste time in cutscenes and stuff like that, so we just want to get through this as fast as possible. So grab our first scout fly or this area. And then we will head to Forbidden Jungle. Forbidden Jungle is certainly the better area to go to in the first ones, just because there's something we need to do in Forbidden Jungle which really helps us in Sentinel Beach. And I'm missing that up. But okay. So we're just gonna make our way up here and hopefully we can do this pretty quickly. So we're gonna head left here rather than straight on. And the reason for that is we come back to this area later on in this So we're just gonna drop down and we're gonna speak to this guy.
What do you have in the basket?
Nothing to talk about. Damn monsters patrolling the ocean. Took a bite out of the fishery. Another goblin up me hatch.
No matter what I try, I can't seem to catch a single fish in this river.
Woo! Hey, Navy, it's your breath.
You think you can do better? Try swooping up river fish with a tiny net. I'll give you a power step if you can catch 200 pounds of them crabs. And then I'll let you a trip here. Use my speedboat to get to Misty Island. You want to try the challenge?
There are 2 types of good fish to catch. 1-pound fishies and 5-pound fishies. If you miss 20 pounds of good fish, then I'm gonna take my net back from you. There are poisonous eels in this river. Catch even a 1 of them boogers, and you'll poison the whole darn catch.
This little mini game is a lovely little mini game. I think that's because I like the music to it. But the thing about this minigame is that it's surprisingly difficult at times. Like, I failed this more times than I'd like to. Just because it's so easy just to accidentally catch one of these eels and ruin the whole setup. It's so easy just to miss a few fish and get a bit frustrated and stuff like this. So just gotta keep concentrated.
Stay
hope that the eels come like wide out like that one did there, so it's relatively easy to dodge. Oh, 2 in a row. That's the annoying thing, when they're 2 in a row and they're sort of, and you just go the wrong way the first one, that's what's really
keeps steady for.
Clever, missed that one. Oh, see, we can only miss up to 20, so that's not too bad, to be honest. The eels certainly start to become more plentiful as it goes on, as this little sequence is spreading.
Here comes the big one. Hold steady.
Whoa. Steady for. Don't want to risk getting that eel back, so just a few. Maybe that's not too bad. We should be. There we go!
You caught 200 pounds of fish! Not bad for a couple of landlubbers. Here's the power cell, I promised. And you can use my boat at the village dock whenever you like.
That's an important one to do, just because obviously it unlocks the whole of the Misty Island area, actually. You can't go to Misty Island without doing that. So that opens up a whole new area, but it's also just a good early power cell to get in this area as well. So we're going to kill a few lurkers, who obviously we first met in that opening cutscene. They are the sort of like those foot soldiers of the bad guys. So what Dax is talking about there is that you can swap 90 orbs for a power cell with many of the NPCs in this game. So obviously we just got 90, which allows us to swap with several of the people in the first village, in Tandover Village. Which is pretty cool. But what we're going to do quickly now is we're just going to grab some more orbs that we have missed, apparently. Or that we couldn't get, I should say. And that's the ones in this thing, just here. Which we obviously need to unlock with the Lurico. Grab these four, which are easy four to miss. And then, so we're now going to use the jump. We should be able to get another power cell, which we do by going in here. So that one is just a door, but essentially you need the blue eco in order to open the door there, so that was why I was able to get that. And now, that's a bit annoying.
Let's get up on that machine and break the mirror diverting the precursor beam.
So what Dex is talking about there is, we will just do that actually, it's a good time to do it. Probably the biggest mission in this area, given to us by the mayor, who talks about how essentially the village energy beam is being diverted as it was there by that mirror. We broke the mirror, and now we've got to reconnect the energy beam.
How would you hickey scatter all of the jungle but redirect the eco beam?
And because... And as Zach says, they're directed there all over the jungle. And the nice thing about being all over the jungle is it sort of leads us around the area quite nicely. So we'll come back to this mission. We won't do that one straight away. What we will do instead is we are going to head down here. We've got a few lurkers and stuff. Okay. I'm hoping that we're not going to get hit by that lurker, so I'm just going to spam spin for a moment. So yes, there we go. I'm going to grab these two orbs. I'm pretty sure those are the only two that we've missed so far, so I'm going to leave it and jump this way. And then we'll reach it. So, we're not going to quite get to the top of the tower just yet. What we're going to do is we're going to come up here. And then we're going to jump around, and this is really easy to fall off, so I'm just going to be careful. I don't want to take any too many unnecessary risks. But yeah, so that's a pretty out-of-the-way scout climb that I've missed many times before. I didn't want to miss it. And now I'm going to start climbing this tower, hopefully. Normally it'd be fully charged with Blue Eco, so all of these boxes would be breaking before you, I suppose. Because we went to get that scout climb, we lost our full charge. But we can re-get that. We get another scout fly, the lower tanks, orbs, and then we go trigger these. So the nice thing is about standing on this one is that it triggers them all. means we don't need to keep the blue eco the whole way around, which is nice. I'm not going to try and do any silly jumps. Just because it's very easy to fall off this thing and having to climb back up is a real time waster. So something that I never noticed first time here is that you can actually press this button in the middle. Just didn't think it was a big obvious button for some bizarre reason. And because of that, I completely missed the next two power cells, which we're going to get the first time I played through this game. Obviously, now I know better.
Yeah, so we got a precursor launcher here, but you aren't powered up with the blue stuff. So it ain't gonna help us!
As you have been there by Daxter, we do need to unlock some more blue eco in this area, and indeed in Central Beach as well. The way we do that is by reaching that building just there, which is... building, I say, it's a structure. This structure here, which is the blue eco vent. And this is the mission that is given to you by Kira, if you talk to her straight away. She talks about closed eco vents and how there should be something, a switch in the forbidden jungle. This is the switch.
Wow, did you see that? Blue eco vents have been activated all over the world. I knew there was a way to turn them on. There must be places to draw the other eco vents as well.
So you can quickly head over here and just use this launcher, seeing as we couldn't use it before. It's important to do, and now we can obviously enter this door. Another launcher, and then we will head across. And take on what will be the first boss of this playthrough, of this race, I guess. I guess it's kind of a race. Should be okay, this isn't too bad at all. Safe to hit. There we go. Ow! I did not expect you to do that. There we go. Okay. Good. We should hopefully be able to get back another bit of health from these little guys. There we go. Cool. Feel a little bit safe. Don't know why. Occasionally, these little guys don't retract their spikes till really late, which is really sort of annoying. So there we go. So we should be able to take out this dark eco plant now. And in doing so, all of those little tentacles that have been sprouting out all over the place, they end up dying, as you can see over there. We get another power cell, which is always great. But the really weird thing about this is that you get five of the most stupid orbs in the entire game. Bounce on this guy's head, and you can get orbs. I have no idea why, but you can. And you can only get five of them. But those are five really easy to miss orbs, and I missed them. Like, it took me so long to find them. And it's really annoying as well, just because like it's completely counterintuitive. So I'm going to grab all of those orbs, and then we are now going to go back to the whole reconnecting the energy beam mission. So the energy, the eco beam mission, which is over here at the moment. That's really annoying. I didn't mean to miss. Obviously, I didn't mean to miss that orb, but then go get it. So it's not too bad. Cool. Okay, so this is what we wanted to get to. Get to here. We can now use this to aim at that one. So hopefully we should be able to finish the Forbidden Jungle within this first episode. That would be really good. Let me do that. Let me take this out flat. I think we're pretty good at the moment. I think we are. Don't think I've made any. I don't think I've missed anything. We get those two orbs. And then just go there. There we go. So, okay. Now the important bit. This bit should tell us if I've done this right or not. If I've missed anything, it will come up here, and I'll be really annoyed, and we'll have to go through fetching the whole level again, which will suck. But if we're right, this should be our final wall. Yes! This should be our scaffolding. Oh, okay, good. So that's a really good start, that's really, really solid. We've got 3.5 minutes.
Alright! You found all the scaffolds in this area!
Yeah, that's really good. Now to aim over here. This will be the end of the Forbidden Jungle, which is a really good start, actually. Very happy with this. So I didn't mean to fall down here, that's not too bad, that's not going to cost me too much time. So the reason we want to fall down here, though, specifically, is because of these orcs here, which are part of Sand of the Village's orcs and are really easy to miss. And so we will redirect. Sweet, so we have 3 minutes. That's a really good start. Now what I really need to hope for is we get 240. 240 orbs is a really important number for us. So we have 231. We need 9 orbs. A little bit of time there obviously for porting, but it shouldn't be too bad. The reason we want 240 is because of the Oracle. So the Oracle gives us 2. Yes, this is good. He gives us 2 power cells for 120 orbs each. So as long as I nail all the jumps, there we go. Hopefully, we can zip through all this talking.
Who awakens the Oracle? Quit. One of you has the light within. From before time, I have watched and waited for the true hero to return. Present to me 120 precursor orbs for each power cell I contain.
Okay,
so for your gift, another power cell is yours.
Okay, that's great, that's great. Second one.
Come on, there we go. Yourself worthy. Here is a power cell.
Good, so that really helps us. That's why I clicked those 5 orbs there, because we just got 240. That really helps us. Obviously we now have 0 precursor orbs, but that's not too much of an issue. Oh, that jumps at me. Okay, so we have 1 minute left, so I'm just going to try and get,
Hey! Let's go check out old Fishbreath's speedboat at the dock!
What do we want to do? We can talk to them. Let's talk to the mayor. Actually, no, because we don't have the 70. The 90 we need. Okay. So, I'm just going to grab this scout fly. And then we've got to head across. There's an orb there. The scout fly around here. 5. Okay. Okay. So, we've got 15 seconds. I miss something in this leg rush. Usually I sail on the bottom. The reason for that is you end up on top of it. 3, 2, 1, stop! Okay, so in this episode we have 247 precursor orbs. Obviously we spend 240 of them. We have 14 power cells, which is a really good start, actually. And we've completed the Forbidden Jungle. We've now got to do Sentinel Beach. Okay. So that's a really good start to this Let's Play. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope you'll join me on the next episode, where obviously we will continue this. And, yeah, hopefully you'll get through Sentinel Beach. We might actually reach Fire Canyon. I don't know. But, yeah. I don't actually know. What I'm going to hopefully do next time is I'm actually going to see where I am relative to the guys I mentioned earlier, to Teal Game Master and to Satcoms, just to see where they were relative to here, and, you know, just make sure that this stays a sort of competitive sort of thing. But yeah. But anyway, I hope you have enjoyed this episode. I hope you will...
Hey guys, so I wanted to add a few little statistics at the end of every video because I really love my statistics and that's just something I like doing. So we have some statistics here for various times for individual levels. You can see in the final column that we have added a new competitor to this race, as it were. A guy called Electro Soul, a YouTuber called Electro Soul, he started his own Let's Play with Teal Game Master and Satcoms as they were doing it, so virtually at the same time, but I never got to see his videos before I recorded my one, so unfortunately I won't be referring to his stuff or anything, because which is a bit of a pity, because he's really, really good, actually. He has some fast runs, as you can see. But yeah, so there's that. And I just wanted to let you know that obviously he's here, I'm going to include some of his statistics and stuff like that, and you should definitely check out his run, because his run's actually pretty, pretty good. And then, the other thing I wanted to say is, obviously, so the 30 minutes, as mentioned in the video, I start my 30 minutes from the beginning of the first cutscene in this game, which is obviously when you see that swirling dark eco a bit. Now, the other guys, they actually started their race really on first input, so when you first start controlling Jack. And because of that, I will be providing an adjusted time for all of these. So all these times are essentially just estimates, and they're not completely correct. And hopefully I'm going to be able to have a final time when actually, you know, we compare all the individual times at the end, and then we'll actually have a complete fair race. Hopefully I haven't garbled that too much, and I hope you will enjoy this series, because it's a really, really good game, and I really enjoy it, and I think it's a great race too. So, I hope to see you on the next episode.